100 Years of Solitude is a 1967 novel by the Colombian author Gabriel García Márquez. Márquez won the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1982, and 100 Years of Solitude is usually considered not only his greatest work, but also one of the greatest novels in world literature. Its importance lies in several things. Its reimagining of the history of Latin America in highly symbolic, mystical terms. Its use of magical realism to incorporate and confront extreme issues such as incest, insanity and murder. Its broad sweep. Its gallery of grotesques and archetypes. Its continual play with notions of time and fate. Above all, its originality and the profound influence it's had on subsequent generations of novelists. It can be a difficult novel to get into and even to like. There are no heroes in here and no really enduring characters with whom the reader can fully engage. When it was first published, many of the reviews it garnered were indifferent. The Nobel Prize-winning Guatemalan poet Miguel Angel Asturias thought it plagiarised a novel by the French writer Honoré de Balzac. Another Nobel Prize winner called it watery poetry. On the plus side, it is written in a straightforward prose style, so unlike many modern innovative novels, it doesn't require decoding on a sentence-by-sentence basis. To say it's a family saga is a bit weak. It's under 500 pages long, but it follows seven generations of the same family, and it contains nearly 30 important characters, some of whom are more marginal than others, but none of whom is really consistently centre stage. It begins with a man called José Arcadio Buendía, who is haunted by the corpse of a man he killed in a duel, and it tells how he, José Arcadio, along with his wife, founds a settlement, Macondo, which forms the novel's setting. In old age he goes mad and his family tied to a tree, where he dies. To its fans, 100 Years of Solitude is a modern myth on a par with Virgil and Homer. But I'd question the depth of the resemblance between magical realism and pre-scientific myth. Others see it as an important milestone in the emergence of the literary voice of the developing world, but I'm not sure about that either. All the characters have Spanish names, so are presumably at least part descended from the imperialists of the 16th and 17th centuries before Colombia gained independence. With so many characters, so much shape-shifting, and so much in the way of decline and fall, I also worry about the novel's moral centre. But of course, my personal view is worth very little. You read it.